Happy 400.
I tell you, people are just constantly looking up. We don't think that we'll be able to see anything, and we haven't been able to see any of the parachutes from where we are right now. But everybody is looking around. They have their cameras out. They're trying to see this pivotal moment happen right now. I'll tell you, once they are recovered, the ship that is out there that is going to recover them will pull right through here at Port Canaveral. It is an epic sight to be able to see those rockets and to be able to see that Dragon space capsule pull through a port like this. But we're just now seconds, if not less than a minute away from this historic touchdown. But you can just feel that people are excited about what is happening right now.
Right. It is very exciting to watch. Leroy, as we watch this all happening, what is the moment that people in Mission Control say, okay, our work here is done?
Well, the big event was the parachute deploy. So we saw a good deploy of four mains. And from that cheering, it sounds like maybe they've splashed down. And so, you know, they're going to hit
less
the water.
Than 10. There we go.
There we go. You've seen it. That thing looks great. So the vehicle is upright. And
let's
so it's
listen.
A bit of a thud, but the shock absorbing mechanisms are sure work fine. And the crew's just readapting to gravity and waiting for the folks to come here.
Inspiration 4, on behalf of SpaceX, welcome home to planet Earth. Your mission has shown the world that space is for all of us and that everyday people can make extraordinary impacts in the world around them. Thank you for sharing your leadership, hope, generosity, and prosperity. And congratulations on your incredible journey.
Thanks so much, SpaceX. It was a heck of a ride for us. Just getting started.
Copy, just getting started.
There you heard it, the splashdown for Inspiration 4 crew. Leroy, what is going through your mind as you watch this happen?
Oh, this is kind of reminds me of coming down in the Soyuz spacecraft, the Russian Soyuz. It's a capsule. Of course, we didn't splash down. We landed on land, but it's a kind of a similar impact at that speed. There's not too much difference. The only difference would be that once you're on land, you're not bobbing around in the sea, so there's no seasickness per se. But anyway, it's a great feeling to be back on Earth. And, you know, at this point, they're waiting for the rescue forces to pick them up and open the hatch and get them outside so they can take that first breath of Earth air.
Yeah. Tell me, Dr. Mundy, what is that first breath of Earth air like?
It is an interesting experience because you miss a lot of the smells and the sights and the sounds that you don't get in space, and you don't always realize it until you come back. So breathing that air, whatever it happens to smell like outside, whether it's the salt air there, I'm sure is what they will smell whenever they open the hatch and they're out there in the ocean. They'll smell that fresh salt air first thing. And then I heard a lot of people talk about the sounds and birds and things that they're not used to hearing. Something like that might also sound really interesting.
And Dr. Kamande, let me ask you, as they wait to be picked up, as they wait for someone to open the hatch, is there then any type of medical evaluation on the other side of this? And what does that evaluation then look like?
Well, I'm sure that these folks will have some medical evaluation as soon as they're removed from the vehicle. They're going to make sure, you know, first of all, that they're feeling okay, because as Leroy mentioned, they might feel a little seasick out there when you're bobbing around and you don't have any reference line to look at to make sure that you don't get seasick. But that shouldn't be too serious, and they should be able to come off, hopefully stand up and walk around on their own. They'll get a general medical check, but, you know, they weren't up there all that long, so they shouldn't have too many side effects of being in space very, very long.